actually, it's a show of hands who actually knows if they've had the meningitis vaccine. Someone actually know? Oh, nice, that's impressive, I like that. And anyone that doesn't know or knows that they haven't had it? Alright, okay.
Good,
all right,
good.
Thank you. Hello, we are Tom, and we're from Claysmore School. I'm Nikita, Finance Director.
I'm Callum, and I'm the Managing Director.
I'm Seb, and I'm Head of Products.
We are a social enterprise raising awareness for meningitis in teenagers and young adults.
Our main objective is to spread awareness for the ACWY vaccine, which is given to pupils in year 10 and recommended just before attending uni.
Our main message, get the vaccine.
We often get asked why we chose to do meningitis. And our reason is this. We discovered that 3 teenagers in Bristol had died from meningitis in the past 18 months.
A third of students eligible for the vaccine don't actually get it. And when we brought this to the group, it was true. In fact, 3 of us didn't have the vaccine.
Our research had discovered that meningitis has been on a massive increase with the W strain, from 22 cases in 2009 to 220 in 2016. And this number will just keep going up.
A common idea among people when they hear about meningitis is, it won't happen to me, and it could. If 10 people in this room were to get meningitis, 6 of you would be left with lifelong disabilities such as loss of limbs or loss of hearing. 1 of you would die, and that only leaves 3 out of 10 left to live their lives unscathed.
So how do we spread the word? We use social media to reach our target market, which is ages 14 to 25, using Instagram, Twitter, Facebook and YouTube. We post updates about our progress and meningitis itself.
We've also been raising awareness through Facebook advertisement, and we've also been selling wristbands to pupils at school and at multiple trade fairs.
We also have a website which has a blog page, a team page, some facts and links about meningitis, and we really focus on this as the centre point to our whole campaign, and all of our social media does lead back to it.
We have contacted student unions, local schools and done assemblies in our school. We are in contact with Salisbury Hospital, the NHS, and have had a press release which led to an interview with Wessex FM.
One of the highlights of our campaign was meeting Gemma Pressman, a girl who got meningitis while doing her second year at university. She's been a great help. We got in touch through Meningitis Now, which is the largest meningitis charity in the UK.
Now, Gemma was put into an induced coma and she woke up completely paralysed and she was only 19 years old. Here are some photos of her before meningitis, in the induced coma and afterwards, and although you can't see it in focus, she's actually in a wheelchair.
Gemma was on a ventilator for 3.5 months. She had to learn how to walk, talk and eat all over again. She'd been in a wheelchair for 4 years and then at the age of 23. Before, she was just a normal girl dreaming of being a barrister on court, but all of this was put on hold due to meningitis.
However, we're delighted to say that a few weeks ago, she took her first steps with the aid of a walking frame. She really was a great support for our campaign and gave us a glimpse into the life of meningitis survivor.
So what are we going to carry on doing? Well, firstly, we're going to sell more wristbands and share out more leaflets.
We also had celebrity chef Cyrus Todibala support the cause. He lost a friend to meningitis at the cookery school, so he loved the idea of what we're doing.
And we'd like to send this national, and we're doing this by contacting newspapers, radio stations, and Meningitis Now even wrote a blog post about us, which really helped with publicity.
So guys, please just get the vaccine. Thank you.